Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreyasa Vijay. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 7th of October. At least three terrorists neutralized in encounter in India's Jammu and Kashmir. Afghan people must come first in peace process, says President Ghani. And curfew imposed in parts of Sri Lanka after COVID-19 cluster detected. And now for all the details. Terrorism continues to be the main challenge in Jammu and Kashmir, where terrorist groups have time and again tried to change the status quo of the territory. In the latest, at least three terrorists were killed in a night-long encounter between terrorist and security forces in Shopian district in India's Jammu and Kashmir on Wednesday.
Security forces killed three terrorists in India's northern Shopian district of Jammu and Kashmir territory during an overnight encounter, police said on Wednesday. Based on specific inputs, a search operation was launched by security forces in Sugan Zainapora area of Shopian district, but militants fired upon the forces, to which they retaliated and the firefight began. Combing operations were underway till the last reports came in. Terrorism continues to be the main challenge in Jammu and Kashmir, where terrorist groups have time and again tried to change the status quo of the territory. India accuses Pakistan of supporting militancy in the area, as well as training and infiltrating militants across the border to spread unrest in Kashmir Valley. Pakistan has always denied the allegations.
An association of Indian farmers leading railway blockade protest against the new farm laws on Wednesday turned down the central government's request for a meeting to resolve their concerns. The protesting farmers believe the laws would lead the government to stop buying their produce at guaranteed prices, leaving them at the mercy of private buyers.
The Kisan Mazdoor Sangharsh Committee and Association of Indian Farmers on Wednesday turned down the central government's request for a meeting on October 8 to resolve their concerns regarding the recently enacted farm laws. Members of the committee, which is leading railway blockade protests in northern Punjab state for the past 14 days, said they received a call and email from India's Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar for the meeting, but they believe the government is still not serious about their concerns. The government insists the new rules give farmers the option to sell their produce to private buyers, while it would still purchase it at the minimum support price. But such assurances have failed to mollify millions of farmers who believe they will be left at the mercy of big corporations.
बिल्कुल 100% किसान के जो उल्ट हैं, किसान के लिए मौत के वारंट हैं। इससे हमारी मंडी भी चले जाएगी, हमारी खरीद भी बंद हो जाएगी, किसान जमीनों से अपनी जो खेतों से बाहर हो जाएंगे, जो बड़े बड़े कारपोरेट घराने हैं, अडानी हैं, अबानी हैं, उसका देश के बाजार और मंडी पे कब्जा हो जाएगा।
Meanwhile, India's opposition Congress party leader Rahul Gandhi on Wednesday drove a tractor in Punjab's Patiala city during a rally to show his support to the farmers. Prime Minister Modi's government has defended the farm laws as reforms to help rid India's vast agriculture sector of antiquated laws and allow farmers to sell to institutional buyers and big retailers such as Walmart.
India's Health Ministry on Wednesday informed the number of recovered COVID-19 cases in the country has exceeded the active cases tally by more than 4.8 million. This comes at a time when COVID-19 cases tally has crossed the 6.7 million mark in the country.
The number of recovered people from COVID-19 in India has exceeded those with active infection by more than 4.8 million across the country, informed the Health Ministry statement on Wednesday. recovery rate in India has surpassed 85% at the time when the country's COVID-19 cases tally has crossed the 6.7 million mark, with at least 104,555 deaths. Meanwhile, as the fight between health workers and the deadly virus continues around the world, frontline warriors, including doctors and nurses of Hindu Rao Hospital in Indian capital New Delhi, have been protesting against delay in salaries. The doctors said they have been working without salaries for around 4 months now and want immediate action in this regard.
हमारी सैलरी हमें 4 महीनों से नहीं मिली है. अब भी ये लोग कह रहे हैं कि 2 महीने और लग जाएंगे यहाँ पे, जबकि अपने ही एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ब्लॉक में ये लोग रेनोवेशन भी करवा रहे हैं, लेकिन हमारे लिए इनके पास पैसे नहीं हैं.
In India's West Bengal also, where annual Durga Puja festival brings in business for idol makers, this year they are facing hardships as no major celebrations are being done in the state as well as other parts of the country. The festival of Durga Puja celebrates the victory of Hindu goddess Durga over the demon king Mahishasura. During the 10-day celebration, the goddess is worshipped in her 9 different forms and then her idols are carried in huge processions to water bodies where they are immersed. Amid the outbreak of COVID-19, large gatherings, processions are banned this year.
In news from Pakistan, temperatures have risen on the political landscape in Pakistan since the opposition launched the Pakistan Democratic Movement last month. A Pakistani court has formally charged former President Asif Ali Zardari in 2 corruption cases, and there is a case of sedition against 3-time former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif and 40 others.
Pakistan government has registered a sedition case against former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif, his daughter Maryam Nawaz and 44 others, including Pakistan-administered Kashmir Premier Raja Farooq Haider. Separately, a court in Islamabad charged former President Asif Ali Zardari in 2 corruption charges. The cases against these high-profile names come as Zardari's PPP, Pakistan's People's Party, and Sharif's PML and Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz Party prepare for a large anti-government rally targeting Prime Minister Imran Khan. Sharif's PMLN is a leading member of the Pakistan Democratic Movement or PDM. PMLN and 8 other opposition parties came together to accuse the military of meddling in politics and of rigging elections in 2018 that brought Khan to power. Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf party has denied role in registration of the FIR. The sedition case against Sharif, filed by a private citizen in Lahore, is based on speeches made by him and his allies in which they attacked the country's powerful military for alleged political interference. Sharif is currently in London for medical treatment, although government officials have stated that they will ensure a court trial against the accused.
Moving on, Afghan President Ashraf Ghani on Tuesday said the Afghan people must come first in peace negotiations, while reiterating the need for a nationwide ceasefire to move the process forward. He made the remarks as the teams of Afghan government and the Taliban have so far failed to agree on procedural rules before starting direct talks. Afghan President Ashraf Ghani, during his Doha visit on Tuesday, stressed the need for inclusivity in the peace process and said the Afghan people must come first in peace, while reiterating the need for a nationwide ceasefire to move the process forward. Speaking at a think tank event, President Ghani recalled the 2018 Eid ceasefire between Afghan forces and Taliban, which he said was a sign that Afghans can agree on peace. Ghani arrived in Doha on Monday as the negotiating teams of Afghan government and the Taliban have so far failed to agree on procedural rules before starting direct talks.
Peace in Afghanistan cannot be the peace of one group. Peace in Afghanistan cannot be the peace of factions. Peace must be the peace of the people.
Meanwhile, Abdullah Abdullah, the chairman of the High Council for National Reconciliation, arrived in India on Tuesday afternoon for a 5-day visit to meet top Indian leadership, including Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Abdullah's visit is part of an outreach to key countries in the region for support for the intra-Afghan negotiations in Doha. Moving on to news from Sri Lanka, authorities in Sri Lanka imposed a fresh curfew in 17 police divisions, including 14 in the Gampaha district, with immediate effect on Wednesday to curb the fresh wave of COVID-19 virus. The island nation reported the new cluster of infection earlier this week, reporting its first community infections in 2 months.
Sri Lankan authorities on Wednesday imposed curfew with immediate effect in 17 police divisions, including 14 in the Gampaha district, where a new cluster of the infection was reported earlier this week. This comes as all public gatherings in the island nation have been banned across the country. Health authorities said early Wednesday that the outbreak centered at a garment factory in Gampaha has risen to 830 confirmed cases, while more than 1,000 people have been asked to quarantine at their homes. The Health Ministry ordered a halt to gatherings such as exhibitions, parties, conferences, indoor or outdoor events, carnivals, musical shows and processions. The Lankan government had already imposed a curfew in 2 towns in the suburbs of capital Colombo, where many of the patients live, closed schools and restricted public transports. The cluster emerged on Monday, a day after Sri Lanka reported its first community infection in 2 months. The country has reported over 4,000 cases during the pandemic, with at least 13 deaths.
Lifelike panoramic scenes from a village with huts, a bridge and even a waterfall have been recreated on a block of wood fashioned into a glass top table by a sculptor in northeastern India. The sculptor has spent about $2,300 to create the art piece.
Ningwan Zingkai, a sculptor, has carved a table with a waterfall, bridge, lights and even a stream flowing into a lake under it, creating a lifelike panoramic scene of a village in India's northeastern Nagaland state. Zingkai, who makes pots and other items with clay brought from his village in Ukhrul district, said he spent over a year in completing the masterpiece, which was carved out of a block of a huge wood block at his house at Dorogojan in the outskirts of Dimapur town. He said he spent nearly $2,320 to create the art piece. Zingkai revealed that his next project is going to be based on the theme of Christmas and he wishes to make a landscape of Jesus and his 12 disciples. He hopes to showcase his work to the visitors who come to Nagaland.
A two-day mountain biking festival drew adrenaline junkies to India's Himalayan desert region of Ladakh this week. The event aimed to promote and diversify the scope of tourism in the Union Territory. Authorities in India's Himalayan desert region of Ladakh organized a two-day mountain biking festival this week to promote and diversify the scope of tourism in the Union Territory. Organizers said they hoped to draw adrenaline junkies from across the world for adventure tourism in Ladakh, which is mostly dependent on local agriculture and cultural tourism. The festival invited both professional and amateur riders to participate in the event from across the country. However, only few could make it to the final round.
Well, basically this is for a promotional, for mountain biking promotional in tourism sense. So this is to diversify the tourism industry in Ladakh and mountain biking fits perfectly.
Ladakh is one of the highest inhabited places in the world above sea level. It is also strategically important from the perspective of India's defense line, especially since tensions with China aggravated in the region earlier this year. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.